Good morning, students. Welcome to IFS lecture number 4. So today we'll start with the new concept, that is dealers in stock exchange. So far we have just a glance. We have studied the meaning, definition, then features of stock exchange, then functions of stock exchange in detail. So in today's class, we'll study there are various players or else there are various dealers who are actively taking part in the stock exchange. So this question has been arisen in 2019 question paper also. So please pay attention. So let's begin with one by one, the financial intermediaries and especially the dealers in stock exchange. So in this slide you can see there are various types of dealers who are working, that is brokers, jobbers, tarainiwalas, odd lot dealers, remisers and authorized clerks, as well as one more is there that is important, speculators. Okay, in detail we are going to study about the same. So let's begin with this concept one by one. So as already told, speculators, that is bull, bear, stag and lame duck. So in detail we'll study about the same. So the first dealer in the stock exchange is called as broker. So what do you mean by broker? The term is not new to you. You are familiar with this term, brokers, who are the name. This term is used not only in stock market, even in other fields like who are acting as a commission agents for real estates, or else even in the house rents, or else there are brokers for various other fields also. So what do you mean by broker with reference to stock exchange? So broker is an individual firm or individual that acts as an intermediary between an investor and securities exchange. So what it says, students, broker is a middleman or intermediary who acts as a link between the investor on the one hand and securities exchange or stock exchange on the other hand. Because what is the duty of a broker? He has to buy and sell the securities, shares, debentures or any other investment avenues, investment products of the investor in various stock exchange as well as various companies. So he acts as a middleman who is working on behalf of his client for fixed fees, or it is also called as brokerage. Clear? Because stock exchange only accept the orders from individuals or firms who are the members of this stock exchange. So these brokers are clearly the members of stock exchange. Okay, so there are various players who are there in the market, stock market, and who are called as dealers of stock market. Companies has to be listed for each and every person. Students, there is a norms to be followed. Companies, they have to follow the rules and regulations of the stock market for issuing of the securities as well as withdrawal of the securities. Regarding dividend, there is a rules. Regarding brokers, commission agents, then underwriters, okay, who are the players of the stock market, has to be abided by the rules and regulations of the stock market. So the stock market, just to situate that, there is no gambling, or else there is no scandals which may arise in future. So to prevent all the uncertainties and to give fair view of your stock exchange, only it deals through the registered members who are called as again brokers. Okay. So they are giving the service in the stock market by helping both companies as well as the investors. I hope this is clear. For what they are working for? For a fixed rate of commission, or else brokerage, or else it is also called as fees. They are suggesting you in which companies you can invest, and they are studying your investment pattern, your requirement and the amount of money you have to invest, and your requisites also for long term, short term or medium term. So based on this, they are suggesting you a profitable avenue for your investment. Okay, so who are called as brokers. Then what are the characteristics of a broker? Okay, so some individual or else traits, personality traits we are talking about, individual as well as professional traits which this broker should possess. Okay, the first one comes here, good trading platforms. So it should be easy to use, reliable with minimum downtime, and good stock trading site must offer your free access to advanced trading platforms equipped with all essential features to analyze and trade. So it is important to know in detail about trading platforms offered by brokers before taking a decision. So in characteristics, even we are focusing on the functioning methodology of a broker. Okay, so they are suggesting you, as already I have told you, they are suggesting the good companies, and they are giving you a platform wherein platform is nothing but advanced trading system platforms. Through demat account you have to invest. A such profitable and suggestible investment avenues, nothing but companies they are going to suggest you. So they have to have the good knowledge about this trading platforms, these brokers, because the investor is depending upon the broker, and he's also been paid a commission also, for which their expectation is absolutely high returns. The next feature is transparent pricing. So as already I have told, it could be company, broking company, or else individual broker students. So there has to be transparent pricing. Pricing for what? So whatever charges they are giving you, whatever charges they are charging on the investor, either brokerage, access fees, or else transaction charges, should be very much transparent. It must be made known to the customers. And even there is SEBI who is guiding on this behalf. It specifies what is the minimum and maximum commission to be charged for the investors. And if in case of any scams or any cheating, how the customers can approach and they can get the justice for the mistakes or else the frauds, whatever has happened in case of charging commission. So one is trading platform, another one is transparent pricing will be the features of characteristics of broker. Then the next one is flexible brokerage plans. So these trading companies, they have variety of trading requirements, and even some traders, they want high volume of investment and sometimes they want smaller investments. So one size fits for all brokerage plan will not favor all the traders, because your brokerage and your charges has to be fixed based upon the volume of transactions, the duration. So accordingly, a good stock trading company therefore must offer different types of trading and different types of brokerage plans to accommodate all the types of traders. I think it applies to all the companies, right? The salary, it varies in the companies, okay, because there has to be some eligibility. Similarly, if you go for an education institution, the fees of various colleges based on the structure, the very structure and the quality, again the prices differs. So you cannot expect the same prices or same brokerage plans to be fit for all the types of variety of investment plans. So this decision is ultimately in the hands of stock trading company, and they can absolutely free and absolutely they have to follow the guidelines of SEBI with reference to the fixation of brokerage plans. A small investment, they cannot charge high rate of brokerage plans. okay, and the duration is of small term, that is only 1 year duration, and they cannot expect them to pay a brokerage plans like of your 5 years or 10 years. So based upon your volume of transactions, the duration, they have to fix those brokerage plans. The next one is must offer at least 2-in-1 accounts. What do you mean by 2-in-1 accounts? It means both demat account and trading account are opened at once and are linked to each other. As we already discussed, students, one must have to open demat account through your brokers, which is nothing but dematerialized accounts, to transact with shares and debentures and all the derivatives. So trading account as well as demat account has to be opened once, so that both are linked together, and whatever transaction takes place through your brokers will be known to you. Clear? So similar is the case of our bank transactions, wherein through SMSs, through online banking, we get to know each of the minute issues, also whatever has happened with your bank statement. So one more type of account is there, that is A3, okay, 3-in-1 account. It means demat, trading and bank account are opened at once and linked to each other. A good stockbroker must offer at least 2-in-1 accounts to facilitate smooth trading and transactions. So what is the expectation? Separate account if you follow, and whatever transactions is taken by the broker will not be known to the investors. So to save time, to have reliability and transparency, it is better to have at least 2-in-1 account, that is demat and trading account together. And even it is more better if he offers 3-in-1 account. What is that 3-in-1 account? Bank account, trading account, as well as dematerialized account. Okay, to have a hassle-free transaction. And one more feature is offers both online and offline services. Nowadays, I think the world has gone online due to pandemic, and even before that also, the government had a dream of digitalization. Everywhere, in each and every field, the things were digitalized. Through Aadhaar card, everything was linked. PAN card was mandatory to have all the benefits of the government. So now, even these brokers today have online stock brokers like Zerodha, Fios, etc., who offer services only through an online platform. So the things have become more easy to get the things done. So they have a zero or little physical presence, but what they are giving, only the services which they have given, like online classes, only services can be experienced. But this creates the problems for customers who are not comfortable trading online, or when there are complex services issues to the address. So I think this problem is a universal problem, wherein each system has its own merits and demerits, pros and cons. Through online, you cannot contact the person immediately for your queries to be solved, because it's a time-taking transactions, wherein you have to contact through email or else phone or anything else. Because when in online, one person must be comfortable with the things also. He should know to operate, and what are the pros and cons of this online system also the one must know. But in normal cases, in offline cases, it is not. You can contact the brokers and you can speak to them, you can take an advice and go on with your decisions. So it's better a broker has both online and offline services for their clients. So it would be more better for them. So that also should be one of the features. So the next slide, we'll shortly discuss about the functions of broker. It's almost we have studied. The main function of stockbroker is he has a tremendous responsibility of managing their clients' money. That is more important, no, students? Because when you are handling your own money, whatever care you are taking, it should be more, it should be double than when you are taking care of your client's money. It is their hard-earned money which you are investing in of the company. So see to it that they must be up to date about the latest tax laws, market research and financial news to provide their client with the best return. And we know in this changing dynamic business environment, each of the sector is changing. Okay, I think only the change is the constant factor in this universe. If you look at the government, there is no stability. The tax laws has to be reformed. And if you look into this education field, we are expecting the reformation. And similarly, laws market is not at all stagnant. So one has to update his knowledge with constant research and study of financial news. So then only he can analyze where to invest, when to invest, and how much to invest. And the best of the returns he can assure to his clients. So these financial agents work in a stressful, fast-paced environment, but for the right individual, it can be a rewarding career. So stock exchange, I think for a commerce student, this would be a more favorite source of professional to choose in future, because it is more rewarding, as there is a investment tendency of the youths is towards the stock market also, because nobody has time and they want to double the money within a short period. So then the best source is stock market, and absolutely we have to agree unanimously, there is a risk of losing the money also, provided if you don't study the market, if you don't do the research, because unlike your bank deposits, once I have invested like 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs or whatever investment capacity you have, and I can sit relaxedly for 5 years, 10 years of tenure, whatever I have opted for. But that is not the case in the case of stock market, wherein minute to minute, day to day, and with various circumstances, the share prices may fall or it may rise up. So accordingly, our decision to buy or selling the shares has to be taken. So this function of broker clearly says that they have a tremendous responsibility to manage other, that means clients' money, with reference to their updation of knowledge in single line. Okay. So the next is, after brokers, one more dealer comes here, that is jobbers. Okay. So jobber is a professional speculator and buys and sells the shares for himself. That means he is into this trading business of stock market. He does not have any clients, but his business is to speculate on which way the prices are moving and make a quick profit on it. He does not want to buy shares and keep them for long term as investors do. Okay, so he is in between jobber and who is an independent dealer in securities, you can say. Okay, because he is very much specialized in a limited number of securities, because through proper constant survey as well as research, he has number of listed securities of his choice with which he will be dealing always. So he cannot deal directly with non-members. Okay, so non-members means the general public. He deals with other jobbers and brokers only. That means he is interlinked with whom? Again, the dealers of the stock market only. Whereas your broker is directly connected with the general public and clients. But jobbers are only professional speculator. Please make a note of this. Professional speculator whose duty is to speculate about the favorite or else the limited number of securities of his, and he is giving the suggestion, and he is deals with only their brokers and other type of jobbers. And that means again they are into this competitive line. And then lastly, just look at the difference between jobbers and brokers. Okay, so jobbers, as we have already discussed, they are independent dealers in securities, purchasing or selling the securities in his own name. But whereas broker, he works on behalf of his clients. In other words, he acts as a middleman. Okay. So here, jobber, secondly, He does not deal with the general public, whereas broker deals with the general public. Then jobber earns profit from his operations, that is buying and selling of activities. He earns profit, whereas broker gets only commission because he acts as a middleman between companies and the investors. Okay, so here jobbers on behalf of themselves they are trading, and they can only to the extent of broker with they can trade with other jobbers as well as the brokers who are again the members of the stock exchange. And lastly, each jobber specializes in certain group of securities. They are into, because they are, since they are specialized, you know the meaning of specialization, right? We are going into deep. So with 4 to 5 companies, for example, of their choice, who is running in profit. So those companies share only he is interested in, and with the same he is trying to play a game. But whereas brokers deals in all the types of securities, because the requirement of the clients varies from person to person. One has short-term investment, one is interested in long-term investment, and their quantum of investment is low based on their earning. All these factors has to be considered and they have to suggest them. So this is about difference between jobbers and brokers, which is again asked in 2018 question paper, student. Please make a note of the same. So jobber is a specialized person who works for the profit, who is a specialized dealer in certain group of securities, whereas broker is a middleman, earns commission, and who works on behalf of their clients. So this is about jobbers as well as brokers together we have to study. And in the next class, we will study about speculators in detail and other dealers of stock market. Thank you.